Hey everybody. The 2017 NBA playoffs are going on. So that has put me in a mood to do a basketball card video. So I've got these 1991-92 season Upper Deck Locker Series. So this box is supposed to look kind of like a locker. And Michael Jordan is the star of this series of cards. Now this box came with seven packs of cards. I've already opened up two of the packs. Some of these cards have already been in one of my previous videos. Dennis Scott. You know, all these guys obviously are retired from basketball. Many of them still make their living through basketball, but not as players. Buck Johnson. There's a Michael Jordan hologram card. Dominique Wilkins, Darnell Valentine, Jeff Malone, Billy Thompson, Michael Adams. Chris Mullen. Larry Smith. Dee Brown. Ricky Pierce. Dikembe Mutombo. That's a hard name to pronounce. Dikembe Mutombo. Checklist. Jeff Martin. Dennis Scott. Spud Webb. It's a heck of a basketball player, considering he's only 5'7". Look how small he is. Lots of talent. Sam Bowie or Bowie. Willie Burton. Mark Bryant. Craig Treeling. Cedric Sabilis. I'm not sure the pronunciation. Danny Young. Kenny Smith. So, NBA basketball, 91-92 edition. It says right here, inaugural edition. Contains a rookie standout card. Nobody does basketball like Upper Deck. One, two, three, So yeah, I've got five packs of cards. And the ones I've opened up comprise two packs, so that's seven. Now let's open up another pack. So, let's begin. Fat lever. Yeah, remember this. I'm going to move these right here. I remember this guy. He's still around. He's, first name is Lafayette. He's currently the director of player development for the Sacramento Kings. So this is the 91-92 season. He sat out the 92-93 season because of a knee injury. In the following year, he finished his career. He was a pretty good player. He made two NBA All-Star teams. And this guy could accumulate the triple-doubles like very few players. If you're wondering what a triple-double is, it's when a player gets into double digits in three of the five statistical categories. And see, those categories are obviously points and rebounds and assist, steals, and blocked shots. Now that's five categories. And if you can get into the double digits for three of those, you will have did a triple-double. It's a hard thing to do because, well, the player with the most triple-doubles is, now all these guys are retired, and most of you have probably never heard of these people, but number one would be Oscar Robertson. He actually had 181 games where he did triple-doubles. And right behind him would be, and I won't say right behind, he's a ways back, but Magic Johnson with 138. And with 107 triple-doubles was Jason Kidd. And 79 would be Russell Westbrook. He had 79 triple-doubles. And Wilt Chamberlain had 78 triple-doubles, and Larry Bird had 59. LeBron James had 55 triple-doubles. And then right behind him is Fat Lever with 43 triple-doubles. So he is number 8 on the all-time triple-double list. And that's quite of an accomplishment, because other people on that list, in the top 20 anyhow, are people like Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Charles Barkley. So, I mean, that's quite the feat. And this guy was a guard. I mean, when was the last time you heard of a point guard leading the team in rebounds? And I'm not really talking about barely breaking 10 points on the rebounds. Or 10, I mean, not points, but just double digits, 10. I mean, he had 20 games where he broke, you know, where he got 10 or more rebounds. So this guy was pretty amazing. Dennis Scott. The Magic. Now remember this guy, 6'8", small forward. He went to college at Georgia Tech. He was pretty good. I mean, he was the 1990 ACC Men's Basketball Player of the Year. I mean, he was like the 4th pick of the 1990 NBA draft. I mean, that's pretty good. But then again, you know, he was the leading scorer on the Yellow Jackets team that made the Final Four, so a lot of teams wanted this guy. Now, small forwards are typically a little bit shorter than this guy. He's 6'8". But, you know, the small forward position is probably the most versatile of the 5 basketball positions. Most forwards are usually like 6'6" or 6'7". Scott is 6'8". He still works in basketball. He's a, I believe he's a commentator for NBA TV. I think he calls the games for the Atlanta Hawks also, or maybe just he's an analyst, I guess. Here's Danny Ainge, Trailblazers back in 91-92. He was a guard. And right now, I think he's like the general manager of the Boston Celtics. This guy was good also. All these guys were good, but some were a little bit better than others. I mean, Danny Ainge was the only person to be named a high school first team All-American in football, basketball, and baseball. He went to Brigham Young University. There he was named the National Basketball College Player of the Year, one particular year. And while he was in college, get this, while he was in college, he played, parts of three seasons with the Toronto Blue Jays, Major League Baseball team. After college, he was drafted into the NBA by the Celtics. He completed like a dozen, maybe more, seasons playing for the Celtics and the Trailblazers and who else? Well, the Sacramento Kings and the Phoenix Suns, too. He was a shooting guard. He went on to coach the Suns for three seasons. And then he went to work for the Celtics in management. Here's a checklist. Here's Danny Young. He was a guard. And in the 91-92 season, he was playing for the Trailblazers. He went to Wake Forest University. He also played for the Seattle Supersonics. And the Portland Trailblazers, and the Los Angeles Clippers, and the Detroit Pistons, and the Milwaukee Bucks. So he got moved around a lot. He was good, but he was, no superstar. Here's Delaney Rudd. He went to Wake Forest University. He played in the NBA with the Utah Jazz. And at one point he was also on the Portland Trailblazers. He was a point guard. Six-foot-two. Mark Aguirre, Pistons. He was a forward. He was good. He was a three-time All-Star for Dallas. Won two championships with the Detroit Pistons. And that was after he got traded to Detroit. I wonder if the Dallas Mavericks regretted trading him to Detroit. You trade a guy off, and then they win two championships with a guy that you traded. Nick Anderson. Yeah. Anderson. He works. He still works for the Magic. I'm not sure what his position is with the Mavericks, if it's management or. He does something there. I'm not sure what. I think he's also a commentator with. Fox Sports, Florida. I don't really know too much about this guy, but here's his card anyhow. Okay, here's a superstar. Hakeem Olajuwon. There's a lot I could say about this guy. He has a kind of a strange name, Olajuwon. He was born in Nigeria, I think. He played from the mid-1980s to the early 2000s. He was a center for the Houston Rockets and the Toronto Raptors. Now this guy, he led the Rockets to back-to-back NBA championships in 94 and 95. In 2008, he was inducted into the Basketball Hall of Fame. Now let's see what this card says. Yeah, that's what I thought. This card lists his height at 7 feet. But he himself has said he was only 6'10". Now that's still tall, so, but 6'10 is not 7 foot. He was without a doubt one of the greatest centers to ever play the game. He had a nickname. It was they called him the Dream, because he could dunk the ball so effortlessly that his college coach once said that it looked like a dream. Man, he was really good. An airplane going over. He was a member of the 96 Olympic gold medal winning United States basketball team in the Olympics. He was one of the 50 greatest players in NBA history. Yeah, when he ended his career, he was the all-time leader in blocks, like with close to 4,000. Oh, and I almost forgot. Earlier I was talking about triple-doubles. Well, Olajuwon is one of only four. Yeah, that's right. Four NBA players to record a quadruple-double. So he was in a very elite class. Scott Brooks. Now this guy's currently a coach for the Washington Wizards, I think. And he's a good coach, probably a better coach than he was a player, I don't know. He got, Coach of the Year award or something like that back a few years ago. He was a head coach of, twice for the NBA All-Star Game. So, yeah, I think he was a better coach and player, but he was still a good player. Rory Sparrow, a guard, Sacramento Kings. College Villanova. 6'2". He was a good player, drafted in the 1980 draft. I think he wasn't the first or second round. I think he was like third or fourth round draft pick. I remember him playing for the Atlanta Hawks too. Yeah. That was after this card, obviously. Knicks, Bulls, Heat, Kings. I know he also played for the LA Lakers. What you can remember this guy for? Probably more than anything else, maybe. Or maybe my twisted mind is the only one that thinks like this, but he scored the very first basket in Miami Heat history when the franchise was created back in the late 80s. And last but not least, this guy still earns a paycheck from basketball. He's a TV basketball analyst. He was good. I mean, he was chosen in the 1990 NBA draft. He was a fifth overall pick. So that definitely is good. And the Hornets picked him. And like most basketball players, they average a dozen or so years in the NBA. I think he played 14, 15 seasons, something like that. But he was a shooter. He averaged over 20 points a game. Let's see. Well, his stats are not on here. Well, just take my word for it when I say he averaged over 20 points per game. He played most of his career with the Hornets. But he got moved around a lot later. Seattle Supersonics, the New Jersey Nets, the Miami Heat, the Minnesota Timberwolves, Chicago Bulls, the Bucks. Now, one thing interesting about Kendall is that after he got out of basketball, to keep up his physical conditioning, he took up boxing. And he eventually became a professional boxer. He was 37 years old when he had his first professional bout in boxing. And so anyway, this completes another pack of basketball cards. I've got a fair amount of basketball cards. I don't think I'll ever be able to do videos on all of them. Let's add these to the stack. I wonder if I can spread them all out like this. Anyway, thanks for watching.